This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And this video is going to cover the basic rules for calculating permutations and combinations. If you want to know how these rules came about, I've got a series of videos that goes into much more detail about this. So I will put links up to those videos within this video. And then you can just click those links whenever you want and get more detail. Okay, let's start out with basic permutations. So let's say I've got 5 books. They're all different books. And I want to arrange them on a shelf. And I want to know how many different arrangements of those books I can make. Each different arrangement is called a permutation. And the formula for permutation is really very simple. It's going to be n. And n is going to be the number of items that you are arranging or permuting, followed by an exclamation point. This is read as n factorial. What it means is you take whatever number n is, and you multiply that by all of the natural numbers that are less than it. So if I have 5 books, I'm going to have 5 factorial permutations of those books. If I multiply 5 factorial out, I get 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. I can either do this multiplication manually, I can figure out what this is, or a lot of calculators have a factorial button or a series of buttons you can press so you can get the factorial of any number you want. Okay, but as far as permutations are concerned, if you've got a set of objects and all the objects are different, and you want to know how many permutations of all of those objects there are, it's going to be the number of objects factorial. Okay? Now, you might not want to take all of the objects. So for instance, let's say you only want your 5 books, but you only want to pick 3 of them. And you want to know how many 3 book arrangements, how many 3 book permutations you can make. The formula we use for that is going to be NPR, I'll explain what this means in a second, equals N factorial over N minus R factorial. Now in some places you're going to see NPK, so instead of the R you'll have a K. The formula works out the same. Here's what the letters stand for. The P is because you're doing the permutations. N is the number, the total number of elements in the set of objects you're dealing with. So in this case, the total number of books. So if we fill this in, N is 5. So N factorial is 5 factorial. And then the R is the number of elements that are going to be in each of the permutations. So we want 3 book permutations, 3 book arrangements of those 5 books. So R is 3. That means N minus R is going to be 5 minus 3, and then a factorial sign after that. And then once again, we could put this in a calculator, or we could just expand 5 factorial to 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And the 5 minus 3 factorial, 5 minus 3 is 2, so 2 factorial is just 2 times 1. We could then cancel out the 2s, cancel out the 1s. We would have 5 times 4 times 3, or 60 different 3 book permutations out of a total of 5 books. Okay? Now, the next situation happens when you've got some repeats among the elements. In other words, some of the elements are exactly the same. So for instance, if we took the word Mississippi, M-I-S-S-I-S-S-I-P-P-I, we've got a lot of repeats in that. We're going to have to use a slightly different formula when we're dealing with repeated elements. So what I'm going to do is count how many of each letter I have. So I've got one M, I've got 4 of the letter I, I've got 4 of the letter S, and I've got 2 of the letter P. And also count how many letters there are total. So Mississippi has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 letters. And the formula we're going to use is really fairly simple. All we're going to do is take the total number of letters, which once again we can think of as n, and we'll use the factorial version of that. So we'll have n factorial, or in this case, 11 factorial. And then for each of the elements that repeats, we're going to put in the denominator the factorial version of that element. We'll multiply them all together. So I've got an I repeating 4 times. That means the denominator is going to contain 4 factorial. S repeats 4 times. So the 4 factorial is going to be multiplied by 4 factorial again for the S. P repeats twice. So once again, I'll put 2 in the denominator, 2 factorial. And now I've got 11 factorial over 4 factorial times 4 factorial times 2 factorial. I can expand this whole thing out by multiplying for the numerator 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 all the way down to 1. And for the denominator, I'm going to have 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 for the first 4 factorial. And then that same thing again, 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 for the second factorial, times 2 times 1 for the 2 factorial. I can do that manually, or once again, I could put this in the calculator and find out what that comes to. And that would tell me how many permutations I have from all of the letters, all 11 letters, in the word Mississippi. Okay? And then there's combinations. So combinations are different than permutations. If I have, for example, the 3 letters A, B, and C, and I rearrange them into BAC or CBA, each of those rearrangements is a different permutation. But if I've got these 3 letters, A and B and C, no matter how I arrange them, it's only going to be one combination. So when I deal with combinations, I don't care about the order of the elements. Okay, I'm just taking them as a group. Now, the formula for combinations is fairly simple. It's going to be NCR, just like the NPR we had, but now it's a C because we're dealing with combinations. NCR equals N factorial over R factorial times N minus R factorial. And the N's and the R's stand for the same thing that they did in the other formula that we had, the NPR formula. So what I'm going to do is, let's say I've got 5 books once again, and I just want to have 3 book combinations. I don't care what order those 3 books are in. So since there's a 5 books total, my N is going to be 5, so that's 5 factorial. R is the number of books in each combination, that's 3, so that's 5 factorial over 3 factorial, and I multiply that by n minus r factorial, which is 5 minus 3 factorial. That's going to equal 5 factorial over 3 factorial times 5 minus 3 is 2, times 2 factorial, and I could work that out. Let's see, that would be something like 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 over 3 factorial, which is 3 times 2 times 1 times 2 factorial, which is 2 times 1. The 3, the 2, and the 1, I can cancel those in both the numerator and the denominator. I could divide the denominator by 2 and the numerator by 2, and I would get a total of 10 different combinations, 10 different 3 book combinations from a total of 5 books. Okay, so that's the basics for this. Once again, here are some links. So if you want to see more detail about how these rules were arrived at, you can click on the links and do that. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.